Welcome to The Voltage. Today we're launching the brand new ESAB Renegade Volt ES200i stick and live TIG welder. This fantastic machine runs off of 4 DEWALT FLEXVOLT battery packs and gives you that versatility to really weld anywhere out in the world. It's a very intuitive user interface that allows you to know at what amperage you're welding, as well as how much battery life you have remaining. And at that amperage that you're welding, how much weld time you have approximately before you deplete the batteries. But in addition to welding off of 100% battery pack, this machine offers the versatility to also weld off of 120 or 230 volt power, in case you do have access to outlet AC mains power.
My biggest thing when it's like, it's batteries, right? You're thinking they might have like some sort of voltage drop at some point, it might dwindle down, but none of that. Like, even with almost no battery left, we were striking the arc, just like barely, and it was on. It was lit. We were going full beams the whole way. There was no tapering off. It stayed on until it quit.
It's smooth. I like it a lot. Yeah, I welded an eighth and a 32nd rod. Came out clean, almost slag feel, so can't complain.
Well, it was really smooth. I mean, shocking that DEWALT batteries could actually run a 70-18 eighth inch rod. Like, you know, weld on 3/8 plate without any kind of preheat. I mean, it was sweet, man.
Absolutely. What do you got to show us here?
Yeah, man. So that's eighth inch, you know, eighth inch rod. I did a 3/32nd rod on the backside. I did a tie-in. I mean, it had a really smooth arc start. Really no lag as far as being able to strike an arc, and that was impressive. They said, I think, an hour so far is what they've been welding with. I mean, and it's been jumped between 3/32nd rods and eighth inch rods between, you know, 90 amps and 120 amps. I mean, that's impressive.
Very stable, very clean. I enjoyed it. Kind of kept perfect arc control on it, wasn't wandering. It was really nice.
That was very smooth. I don't think I've had too many stick welders I've tried that are quite that smooth. The start was very smooth. Didn't take but more than but a second time, and I was able to get it start, burn the whole rod, and that was really, really smooth. I mean, that's about all I can say. I'm about speechless after that, to be honest.